स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम बैक वेलकम बैक। गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम बैक। वेलकम टू द एबेकस मैथ्स क्लासेस। आई एम योर एबेकस टीचर मिस गरिमा सिंह। सो स्टूडेंट्स अवर टुडेज वीडियो टॉपिक इज मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ अ थ्री डिजिट नंबर बाय 2, 3, 4 and 5। यस टुडे वी विल टेक 4 digits, 2, 3, 4 and 5. We will do a 3 digit multiplication by these 4 numbers. So, here I have drawn the abacus tool. You are quite familiar with this abacus tool, students. Always, in our sums, we use 3 rods. The 3 rods are units rod or you can say ones rod. The second is tens rod and the third is hundreds rod. But today you can see that I have drawn one more rod here, which is thousands rod. Students, today we will do the calculation in this rod also. So now today we are taking 4 rods: units rod, tens rod, hundreds rod, and thousands rod also, because our today's topic is 3-digit multiplication. In our today's topic, we will take the digits like this. Means the number which contains 3 digits. See, 1, 2, 3. Same way, 1, 2, 3. So today we will learn how to multiply a 3-digit number with the help of abacus tool. See students, this is your abacus tool. Now let's start our today's topic, 3-digit multiplication with the first sum. Now your sum is 241 into 2. As I have already told you that in this topic we will take multiplication by 2, 3, 4 and 5. 4 numbers we will take today. So for this multiplication, as you know that first of all we will take the first digit. We will multiply this 2 with the first digit. Now multiply it. So it's 4. Now students, again I am repeating zero rule. In my previous videos also I have told you what is zero rule. Here we will apply zero rule. Zero rule means that if you will get a single digit in the beginning, then you will apply one zero in front of your number. So now it's 0, 4. Now in my previous videos I have told you that you start your calculation from hundreds rod, but those numbers are 2-digit numbers. Now here you are multiplying a 3-digit number. So you will start your calculation from thousands rod. So your first number will go in 1000 rod and the second number will go in 100 rod. Yes, you will start your calculation from thousands rod for the 3-digit numbers. Now put this 0 in thousands. Now 0 means nothing. So nothing we will put in thousands rod. Next we have to add 4 in hundreds. 4 means put the 4 bit up. Four be up. See, hundred is not four I have added. this I have added and this is complete. Now multiply your second digit with 2. Now students, you apply zero rule when you get a single digit number at the beginning. But here in 3 digit number, if you will get a single digit in the second place, then also you have to apply 1 0 in front of the number. Yes, if you are getting single digit in the second place, then you have to apply 1 0 because it is a 3 digit multiplication. Now this will go in hundreds rod and this will go in tens rod. Now 0 in hundreds rod to 0 means nothing. 8 in tens rod. 8 means take the help of 5. 5 then 6, 7, 8. 6, 7, 8. 5, 6, 7, 8. And this is completed. Now next move to 1. Now multiply 1 with 2. Now 2 ones are 2. Now here you don't have to apply 0 rule. Just directly put this number in 1's rod because it's the last number. So you will put this number in 1's rod. Now 2, 2 means put the 2 beads up in 1's rod or you can say unit's rod also. 1, 2. Now count students. See thousands rod nothing is there. In 100 there is 4. In 10 rod it is 5, 6, 7, 8. And in units rod it is 2. So your answer is 482. I hope students you get this sum with the help of abacus tool. In 2 places you have applied 0 rule. Because it is a 3 digit multiplication sums. So if you will get a single digit number at the beginning, then also you have to apply 0 rule. And if you will get a single digit in the second place, here also you have to apply 0 rule. So I hope you get this sum. Now we will move to the second sum. Multiplying a 3 digit number with 3. Now your second sum is 554 into 3. Now let's start the sum. Multiply the first digit with 3. Multiply 5 with 3. 5 into 3. Now 5 threes are 15. See here you are getting a double digit number, so no need to apply the zero rule. Now your first digit will go in thousands rod and the second digit will go in hundreds rod. Now 1 in thousands rod, 1 means put the 1 bead up. Now 5 in hundreds rod, 5 means put the 5 bead down. I hope students you are doing this sum with me. It is the best way to learn abacus. Now this is complete. Now multiply the next digit with 3. 5 threes are 15. Now here also you are getting a double digit number, means 2 digit number, so no need to apply the 0 rule. Now this will go in hundreds rod and this will go in tens rod. See, hundred rod is repeating. Yes students, you have to repeat the rods. See, thousand, hundred, then hundred, tens. And if in the last place if you will get a 2 digit number, then 10, 1. I will tell you. Like thousand, hundred, then hundred, tens, thousand, hundred, hundred, tens. Then again repeat tens and ones. This is the pattern for for writing the rods. 1000, 100 in the first place. Then in the second place, 100 tens. See, 100 is repeating. 100 tens. Then in the last, if you will get a two-digit number, then tens is repeating. But if it will be a single-digit number, so 10 you will remove and only ones will be there. So what is the pattern? 1000, 100, then 100, 1000, and then tens, ones. So here one in hundreds rod. Where is hundreds rod? This is hundreds rod. So one in hundreds rod. And 5 in tens rod. 5 means put the 5 feet down. Now this is completed. Now the last. Multiply 4 with 3. 4 threes are 12. Now as I have told you, the last number will go in tens rod and ones rod. So 1 in tens rod. See, tens rod is here. 1 in tens rod means put the 1 digit up, 1 rod, 1 bead up, sorry. And then 2 in ones rod. 2 means put the 2 bead up. 1, 2. See, 1 in tens rod and 2 in units rod. Now this is completed. Now count the answer. See, 1 in thousands rod. Then 5, 6 in hundreds rod. Then 5, 6 again in tens rod. And the last 2. So 1662 is your answer. You can do it very quickly, students, with the help of this tool. So we will move to the third sum now, multiplication with 4. Now kids, we will move to the third sum. 3, 4, 9 multiplied by 4. Now, as you know, we will multiply the fourth digit with 4. Now 3 into 4. Now 3 fours are, or you can do 4 threes are also. 3 fours are 12. Now according to the pattern, the first digit will go in thousands rod and the second digit will go in hundreds rod. Now 1 in 1000. Now students, let's add. See, 1 in 1000 rod, 1 means put the 1 bead up. Same way, 2 in 100 rod. So 2 means put the 2 beads up. See, 1, 2. 1 bead up, 2 beads up. And this is completed. Now multiply the second digit with 4. Now 4 into 4. Now 4 fours are 16. Now according to the pattern, see, the first digit will go in hundreds rod and the second digit will go in tens rod. So let's add. See, 1 you will add in hundreds rod. Hundreds rod, 1 means 1 we are adding, we are putting 1 bead up. And 6 in tens rod. 6 means we will take the help of 5. 5 and 1 from down, 6. 5, 6. Now this is complete. Now the last. Multiply the last digit with 4. Means you have to multiply your each digit with 4. Now multiply 9 with 4. It's 9 fours are 36. Now students, see, it's a 2 digit number. So your first digit will go in tens rod and the second digit will go in ones rod according to the pattern. But if you will get a single digit number here, so it will go in only ones rod. You will not take tens. It will go in ones directly. No need to write tens. So this 36, the 3 will go in tens rod and 6 will go in ones rod. So let's add now 3 in tens. See, bead is there. 1, 2, 3. Bead. And now add 6 in ones rod. For 6, take the help of 5. 5 and one digit from down is 6. 5, 6. And this is completed. Now add. Now 1/8000 rod is. Now here you can see 1, 2, 3. Then here 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And the last is 5, 6. So your answer is 1396. Students, till these sums, as you can see, there is no lack of bead. Means whenever you are adding, the bead is there. This means that we are not getting the sums this time which are having lack of beads. Maybe in further sums we will get lack of beads. So please students, watch the video till last. In the next sums we can get lack of beads. Then you have to apply the small prints or the big print formulas to solve those sums. So let's move to the next sum, which is a 3-digit multiplication by 5. Now students, we will move to the fourth sum, which is 4, 3, 5 multiplied by 5. Now as you know, we will multiply the first digit with 5. Now 4 into 5. Now 5 goes up, it is 20. According to the pattern, our first digit will go in thousands rod and the second will go in hundreds rod. So let's add. See, 2 in 1000, the last one. 2 means add 2 beads, put the 2 beads up. Now this is done. Now 0 in 100. Now 0 means nothing. So it is completed. Now next, multiply the next digit with 5. Now 3 into 5. Now it is 15. Now according to the pattern, it will go in 100 slot and the second will go in 10 slot. Now 1 in 100 slot. 1 in 100 slot means put the 1 bead up. And then 5 in 10 slot, 5 means put the 5 bead down. And this is completed. Now the last, multiply the 5 with 5, means 5 into 5. 5 5s are 25. Now according to last pattern, this will go in tens and this will go in ones rod. Now 2 bead in tens rod. See, 2 beads are there, so we can add directly 1, 2. And this is added. Now 5 in ones rod. 5 means put the 5 bead down. Now this is completed and our sum is also completed. Now come, see, 2 in thousands rod. Same way, 1 in hundreds rod. Now 5, 6, 7 in tens rod. And 5 in ones rod. So 2175 is your answer. I hope students, you get this sum. Multiplication of a 3-digit number by 5. Now let's move to the fifth sum. Now kids, your fifth sum is. Now you will think that multiplication by 4 we have done already. Kids, in this sum we will use small prints or big prints. Yes, in this sum we will get lack of beads. So I will tell you how you will apply small prints or the big prints in this sum. So let's start. First of all, multiply the first digit with 4. 5 into 4, it's 5 fours are 20. Now according to the pattern, the first digit will go in 1000 and the second will go in 100. Now 1000 rod, put 2 in 1000 rod. 2 means 1, 2, 2 beats up. Now next 0, 0 means nothing, so it is completed. Now multiply the second digit with 4. 2 into 4, 4 2s are 8. Now as you can see that you are getting a single digit number in the second place. So you will apply 1 0 in front of your number. It is zero rule. This rule explained to you in the first sum. Now 0 8. Now your first digit will go in 100 slot and the second will go in 10 slot. Now 0 0 means nothing. Now 8 in tens. Now 8. 10 is not 8. For 8, take the help of 5. 5, 6, 7, 8. 3 beat from down. 6, 7, 8. 5, 6, 7, 8. And this is added. Now the last. Multiply 6 with 4. Now 6 into 4. Now 6 goes up 20. Now kids, this will go in 10's rod and this will go in 1's rod according to the pattern. Now 2 you have to add in 10's rod. Now for adding 2, you can see that only 1 bead is there. So I have told you that whenever you get lack of beads, you will take the help of small friends. Now what is the small friend for adding 2? See, you have to add 2. So the first number which you will add is 5. Then you have to subtract the friend. The friend of 2 is 3. Now for applying this, the first number which you have to add is 5. See, 2 you have to add in 10's rod. So 5 you will add in 10's rod. But you can see here that 5 is already added. So how you will add 5 now? This means that we can't apply this small friend formula in our sum. So I told you that whenever you can't apply the small friend formula, so you will go for the big friend formula. Now for adding 2, what is the big friend formula? First of all, you have to add 10 and then subtract the friend. Now in big friend, who is the friend of 2? 8. Very nice. Some students have learned these formulas in their finger tips. Very good. Now first of all you have to add 10 and then you have to minus 8. Now I have told you that whenever you will add 10, you will add 10 in one rod up. Now 2 you have to add in 10's rod. So 10 you will add in 100's rod. One rod up. 10 added. Now minus 8 you will do. Minus 8 from the same rod means 10's rod. Minus 8. Now minus 8 means 5, 6, 7, 8. 3 beads down. 6, 7, 8. 10 I have added in. 100 rod means 1 rod up. See, 1 rod up. And 8 subtracted, I have subtracted from 10's rod. See, 10's rod, same rod means. Now 4 you have to add in 1's rod. 4 means put the 4 beads up. 1, 2, 3, 4. And your sum is completed. Now count. See, 2 in 1000's rod. 1 in 100's rod. Here is nothing. Nothing means 0. And here is 4. So your answer is 2104. I hope kids you get this sum. In this sum the main thing is that you are using a big friend formula. For adding 10, just make it in your mind or put it in your mind that you have to add 10 in one rod up. So kids, move to the sixth sum now. Now kids, this is our sixth sum. You can see that I am multiplying a three-digit number again by 2, because in this sum we will use small friends or big friends, because we will get lack of beans. So you will learn how you will apply the small friends on the big friends in this sum. So first of all, multiply the first digit with 2. Now 7 into 2. 7 took some 14, and according to pattern, this will go in thousands rod and this will go in hundreds rod. So let's add 1 in thousand rod. So 1 means put the 1 bead up. Same way, add 4 in hundreds rod. 4 means put the 4 beads up. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is completed. Now next, you have to multiply the next digit with 2. 5 into 2. Now 5 comes up 10. See, it's a double digit number. No need to apply the zero rule. Now the first digit will go in 100 slot and the second will go in 10 slot. Now 1 in 100 slot. Now you can see that student's bead is not there. So when the bead is not there, means the lack of beads. So we will take the help of small friends. Yes, first of all we will go for the small friends. If we can't apply small friends, then we take the help of big friends. So for adding 1, what is the small friend formula? If you have to add 1 and the bead is not there, the first number which you will add is 5. And then you have to subtract the friend. Now who is the friend of 1? Yes, very nice. The friend of 1 is 4. So this is the formula. You can make it by yourself by just learning the friends. But the friends are the most important part. You have to learn the friends, kids. Now for adding 1, you have to do plus 5. Now see, what you have to do in 100 rod means when you have to add in 100 rod. So calculations will also be in 100 rod only. Add 5. And minus 4. Minus 4 means put the 4 be done. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. Put the 4 be done. 5 plus 4 minus. And this is done, and your 1 is added. Now add 0 in 10 slot. 0 means nothing. Now this is completed. Now here we have used the small print formula. Now the last is, you have to multiply 1 with 2. Now 2 ones are 2. You can see that it is a single digit number. So you will not use this 10, you will put only 1s. So put 2 in 1s rod. 1, 2. Now count. Count kids, your sum is completed. Now you can see that it is thousands in 1 bead. Now here is only 5. Nothing means you don't have to leave this rod. Nothing means 0. And the last is 2. And this is your answer. 15, 0, 2. Now the last sum we will do. Yes kids, one last more sum is there. Last sum we will do, but with the help of only 2. Yes, we will not do any calculation. Directly we will put the numbers in the 2. So let's start. Now this is the sum, kids. We will do directly in the 2. Now see, 6 threes are, now you will multiply the first digit with 3. So 6 threes are 18. Now 18, 1 will go in thousands rod and 8 will go in hundreds rod according to the pattern. So 1 we will put in thousands rod, and 8 means first of all 5, then 6, 7, 8, 3 from down. 6, 7, 8. See, 1 and 8. Now you can count it again. Well, 6, 3 is 18. 1 and 8. 18. Done. Now next, multiply it. 3, 3 is 9. Now here 9, you are getting a single digit number. So you will put 1 0 in front of it. So 0, 9. Now 0 will go in 100's rod and 9 will go in 10's rod. So 0 in 100's rod, 0 means nothing. 9 will go in 10's rod. 9 means put the 5 bit down. 5 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 in 10's rod. And in 100's rod, 0, 0 means nothing. Because our number is 0, 9. So 0 in 100 and 9 in 10's. So 9 in 10 we have. Now next, 2 into 3. 3 2's are 6. Only a single digit number, so it will go in 1's. 6, 6, 6, 5, and 1 from down, 6. And your sum is completed. See how fastly I have calculated a 3 digit multiplication sum. Yes, and I have got here, I have made the beads. If you are doing directly in the tool, you can do much faster. So count, see 1, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 8. Here only you can write the answer, it's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And it's 6. So your answer is 1896. I hope kids you get this today's topic. It is multiplication of a 3 digit number by 2, 3, 4 and 5. Yes, in my next video we will take multiplication of 3 digit number by 6, 7, 8 and 9. I hope kids you like my today's video and you get the sums done by me. With this video kids, I have given you a practice PDF. Do that practice PDF in your Abacus notebook and please use the tool. Make sure kids watch every single video and stay tuned to my video to learn more concepts and tricks. Thank you.